guys look at some of the ayat of this surah, inshallah. So we have our teachers here, our grammar teacher, and also our speech teacher, pronunciation speak teacher, inshallah, can help us to get through this ayat, these ayats of this particular surah of the Quran. And it's about pronouncing properly. And that's, it's not so much as we've been taught how much you read, how much you can read. The most important part is how much of what you read is pronounced correctly. That's the main thing. But you can be memorize the whole Quran and not pronouncing the words properly, and really you hadn't memorized the whole Quran. You hadn't achieved what you wanted to achieve. So what we're gonna do, Surah 23, Ayat 1. And this surah was revealed in Mecca, and it says to us, revealed in Mecca, Naqiyatun Mecca, Naqiyah, in Mecca. And as we know, again, which is part of the Adab of reading Quran, we begin with A'udhu Billahi Minashaytan Rajeem. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. So that is the beginning and also the first line. Bismillah, actually the opening rather, of this ayat, the surahs of the ayat. And the, we'll start with number one, of the Quran ayat number one. And it says, قَدْ أَفْلَهَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Can we say that?
Yes.
Let's say that. Alhamdulillah. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ
الْمُؤْمِنُونَ.
Okay. Anybody got any problem with that? All right. Alhamdulillah. This is because we got good teachers.
Alhamdulillah. I do want to add, though, if when we look at this surah, this particular verse we just read right here, the word, the particle, quad means something that has already happened. Mm-hmm. You know, and then we got the word aflaha, which is success. Some people translate this as the believers have already won through, but it literally means success indeed has come to the believers.
Okay.
So it's already has happened. It ain't nothing that we haven't, this has already been done. This in quad is a word that means in the past. It's already happened.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we are in any doubt, in this ayat 1, Allah have erased all of the doubt from the believer.
Right.
That you have already won.
That's right. That's right.
That's revelation. And that's revelation that gives you surety, motivation, and all these other things. Allah said, you, as a believer, because you believe and act upon your belief, you have already won. You have already been successful. So you're successful. I'll praise you to Allah. Then Allah says, ayat 2, الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِئُونَ. So now Allah give us a principle that goes with your success. Why you successful, really. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِئُونَ. Those who humble themselves in their prayers. Alhamdulillah. Those who humble, translate, do we have any different translation? Those who humble themselves in their prayers.
Yeah.
Why do you say humble, not me?
Yeah, those who humble themselves. And you know, really, with all the tenets of the Salat.
Right.
All the tenets of the Salat.
Right. Those
yeah, the word khashu'un, yeah, the word humble is a little bit away from the word khashu'un. Because humble somebody to be like, sound like he's good, nice, kind, whatever. But khashu' is some kind of fear to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you pray, you have a lot of fear because you know exactly where you are standing in front. So you're standing from the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator. So you have all this inside your heart, fear. It doesn't have to be shaken or crying or anything, but you from inside, you know that you have to get all of this fear. Khushu'a.
That's what I'm finna say, khushu'a. That's the word, khushu'a. Which means humility. You fear Allah so much, you know, like your brother saying, you humble yourself before Him. So you because of your fear for Him and you focus directly, khushu'a, you know, on Him, that you fear Him so much that you submit, you're very submissive to Him, you have the humility.
Yeah, so actually this word focus can be connected too. Because if somebody doesn't have khushu'a, that means when he pray, he have his mind somewhere else. So he is praying over here, but actually his mind is somewhere where he was yesterday or whatever, last night. So he don't have khushu'a.
Right.
He don't have fear. He is not inside the whole meaning of pray. Mm-hmm. So here, this word khushu'a is very, very, very important.
Right. And I also might add too, that's why sometimes when you see people standing up and making salat, that means you ain't adjusting your clothing and, you know, jingling, you know, all kind of unnecessary thing. You actually focus on what you do.
That's taking over the khushu'a.
Right. Khushu'a. And then therefore any noise going on around you or any other activity, you ain't paying attention to that because you're so focused. So that don't even bother you, what's going on around you.
I hear a story a long time ago about Imam Ali radiallahu anhu, one of the most important Sahaba. And he was supposed to be in some kind of operation. And you know, the time he used to, and he asked his doctor to do his operation when he was praying. Because he said, when I be in the pray, I'm not going to feel nothing. I be all completely with Allah khashu'.
Mm-hmm.
So if you even cut my arm or do something for me this time, I might not feel it.
Lord.
You need to see this, how he was really completed. And this is a high degree, not everybody can reach it, you know.
Right.
But, you know, we have to strive to go in this way, you know, to just give us our souls, not just our bodies and our minds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we stand in the pray in front of Him.
Right. And Brother Imam, you yourself related a story once in the past. You were doing a kutbah. Well, I can't remember all the details, but it was one of the Sahaba, was praying.
Mm-hmm.
And he got shot with an arrow.
Right.
You know. But he still didn't know he was shot with the arrow because he had khushu'a, you know, what he was doing.
Right. He was into the tenets, all the etiquettes of the prayer. Well, he didn't feel it.
He didn't feel anything.
Until after he tashed him out. After he tashed him out, he realized he had been shot. You know?
SubhanAllah.
So this is an actual story. This is according to what the information.
Mm-hmm. Know his name or
I can't remember that. I know you may have mentioned it once before.
But you know, this is what it's saying. Not just that you are praying, you humble, you looking around.
All this stuff,
you know, this is not even much, you know, prayer.
Yeah, it's a hard job more than a body job. That's what I believe.
Yeah, hard. Yeah,
it's a hard job. So when your heart is busy with something else, or mind busy with something else, you'll be away from it.
Mm-hmm.
But when your mind, your heart, your soul,
yes, exactly,
bless your body, be in it. This is a high degree, and that's what we're supposed to do.
And you know, and if you think of the prayer itself, you know, the prayer originate in the sense of the application of it, how it's going to be. It originates in the mind, in the heart, because you're focusing on what you're going to do. You're thinking about what you're going to do. You're thinking about who you're standing before. You're thinking about what is being said. So you begin thinking about what you're doing, who you're doing it for, and who you're standing before. So alhamdulillah, definitely it's a heart, mind, heart operation other than a physical thing.
The operation just in the mind and heart, when it
I'm saying operation, just what you're doing, you know.
Right.
You know, it's hard. You're getting your mind clear from all of downtown, paying my bills, all fitting in my heart, my dislike of persons, all that is because you're not going for us and our Father, so you want to let that escape, you want to let that go. Mm-hmm. I'm standing before Allah. That's the only way I'm going to really get the benefit of what I'm doing. You know, for my soul. That's what the prayer is for, the soul. You know, for it's a soul thing, mind, heart thing. Mm-hmm. And also it helps us physically too.
Right.
But it's for a soul thing. I want my soul, I want my mind to be clear on what I'm doing and have clear thoughts and clear ideas in my head. Okay. Ayat 3. والذين هم عن النحو مردون
عن اللغو
مردون
والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون
والذين هم عن اللغو مردون so those who avoid vain talk, you know, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it has been said that he said that we, as a human being, we slip more by our tongue than our feet. So we have to avoid vain talk. And vain talk, as we know, is talk that really have no benefit. No benefit for nothing. It's wasteless, useless, non-beneficial talk. And Brother had mentioned this morning, we have to be mindful of time. You know, we're wasting our time and just talking stuff that has no benefit. We should stop that. You know, what is the benefit for me? What's the benefit for humanity? What's the benefit for my soul, for your soul? What's the benefit for the community, the ummah? We gotta. Our conversation should always be those kind of conversations. How could I better help the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in anything other than that? This Quran is teaching us in this ayah, we should avoid it. We should leave it alone. Okay. Ayat 4. والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون. Could we say that? والذين
هم للزكاة فاعلون.
Those who are active in deeds of charity. So this is another quality that the successful believe we should have, that quality of acts, who are active in deeds of charity. And this, that is really just helping. You know, we don't do enough charity stuff. You know, we don't. It's for the Islamic level, in my opinion. It's just my opinion. Islamic level of the zakat, of the charity, is somewhat being missing, is escaping the Muslims. That quality is escaping us. We have to add it, we have to build that up. You gotta make that stronger. And what happened is, it purifies us, our heart, our mind, and bring us closer. You know, that brother helped me, man. He just helped me. Well, if he helped me, just help me. I'm going to help him, just help him. And we spread that. But if we are close-handed, you know the close-handed brother with that bird, he finally killed that bird. He loved that bird so much, right? It's my bird. So we got to stop being so close-handed in the sense of helping each other. You know, we got to help each other, not for the sake of being benefited by you or by anyone other than Allah. See, I'm doing this for the love of Allah. That's why I'm doing this, for the love of Allah. And why it's so important that we make that intention is that we're doing something for the love of Allah, we're going to do the best, we should do the best we can. The best we can do. So we're putting that pressure on us, that added pressure, that added inspiration. Man, I'm doing this for the pleasure of Allah, for Allah to bless me. So that means that it's going to make you and I do better than we're doing. Like we made intentions when Brother Tariq was talking this morning about learning the conversational words in Arabic. So my intention, I'm going to learn this for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So not just for me, but for the pleasure of Allah, so that I can get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through his language. So I put an added, I said, I'm going to buckle down and listen to what this brother's saying and get this pronunciation down, get all these things down that I need to get down, and keep going. So it's a motivation, you know. So that's what we're doing. We're doing it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so we can teach others, we can teach our grandchildren. And they in turn, from us, from Bilal, from me, from Brother Tariq, brother here, Brother Muhammad, our young brother there, inshallah, one day they have students who have learned from them. So somebody got to learn to teach. Somebody got to make the time to learn. Them brothers will make the time to learn to teach us. So we got to take the time to sit and learn so we can teach, inshallah. So we'll be a continuation. We have students, you know, it'll be a reoccurring charity.
Sadaqa charity,
reoccurring. You know, brothers be coming. What's your name, brother?
Khalid.
Khalid. Mm-hmm. I said, brother, I'm a student from Khalid. Khalid was my teacher. He was, now actually Khalid, right?
Khalil
was my teacher's teacher. It's like the hadith, you know? They can go back, they change the lineage of what happened. This is from whoever the hadith was, the guy gave the hadith, then it goes into this, and you know, it actually comes from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is what we want to do. This is what we're going, that's what's happening, that's what we're doing. We don't know it. But eventually, when it's said and done, we're going to all be in writing. We're going to be making history in the United States. Your name going to be in, his name going to be in, all these brothers' name going to be in. This is how I got my beginning. We're going to be able to trace that learning, that teaching from that particular originator of that particular effort back, you know, do that. Okay.
Yeah, brother, I just want to have a little comment about this ayah.
Yes.
وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ Actually, I'm not agreed with this translation. Already say, who are active in deeds of charity. Okay, mm-hmm. The charity actually is sadaqat. And there's a big difference between the words charity and zakat.
Right.
So to have a zakat, this is one of the Islam principles. Mm-hmm. The five principles of Islam, shahadatayn, qam salah, ita'ik zakat, this is number three. Sawm Ramadan and hajjul bayt liman istata'a ilayhi sabil. So ita'ik zakat, giving zakat is not charity. Is only have to be for the people have the nisab, and we everybody knows that the nisab, mm-hmm. you have to reach what it worth of 80 grams of gold. Mm-hmm. If you have in your possession for the whole year, what is exactly the value of 80 grams of gold? Now we have to give zakah for the poor people, and this zakah is 2.5%. So every $100, $2.50. Which is a $1,000, $25 for every $1,000. So for instance, if we say 80 grams of gold is like $6,000, and you have only in your position $5,000, now you don't have to pay zakat. You have to pay zakat only when the money you have, it reaches the value of 80 grams of gold. In these days, that's why the value, this is how we call the value. So when you reach this, that's when you reach an insaf. And now you have to, if you did not give this zakat, now you athen. It's a big sin on you because you don't give it. And this is zakat. And this word zakat, in the meaning of word zakat itself, is meaning when you take something of something, that's make it better. So when you take this $25 over the $1,000 you have, man, you make this $975 is a lot more better and have more blessing than it was $1,000 before you take the tour. So zakat, that's why there's a word of zakat al-anfus. Not only zakat al-mal, so right. Zakat for the money and zakat for the people. So when somebody give efforts from his self to other body, he actually get benefit of that because his value getting better because he gave away zakat. So, but the charity is unlimited. You can give it any time, right. Any amount, whenever you have it. If you feel like you only have $10 and you want to give a charity $5, you're good, go ahead. Right. But this is not zakat. So that's why he used over here in translation the word charity. That's why what catch my eyes. Right. He should use the word zakat. Yes. Charity is not correct word for this ayah because zakat is a principle of Islam principles. Mm-hmm. But charity is not.
And zakat is the word in the Quran, not charity.
Yeah, there is a sadaqat. There is some ayat have this word as sadaqat. And sadaqat, like I said, the charity. That's exactly. I have money I want to give here. I want to give for a poor person. I give it to my masjid. I give it to my friend. Give it to my family. All of this is sadaqat. But zakat, you have to give it. You don't have no excuse. Like if you miss a prayer, you athim. You have a sin. So if you miss your zakat and you have to pay it because you have the nisab, now you're in a sin too. So you have to pay it. And it's going to be a debt on you until you die. Yeah. So if you miss it 5-6 years ago and you said, oh, I don't know that, I should pay it. Okay, it is a debt on you and you have to pay it. Sooner or later, it is zakat.
Right.
You know, it's a big subject and brother, mashallah, he of course he knows more than me in this, but I just want to bring it up. I want to bring it up so everybody can remember it.
And that's good because that's what we've been pointing out a lot. You know, some of the translation, the authors, they missed the point. I mean, it's kind of
he missed the point completely over here.
Right. And that's why I'm talking about today. You know, hitting the bullseye.
Yeah.
See, so that didn't hit the bullseye. The bullseye is zakat.
He's talking about those people who do the zakat. Because there's some people have the money. They have millions and millions. And they never give the zakat. Imagine how thin. And so in the Yawm al-Qiyamah, they will be having this money. They'll be burning on it.
Yes.
It's going to be fire. Then they're going to be burning on it. And they're going to be hit by this money. And they be melted. This is a verse in the Quran saying this. I don't remember the verse exactly, but their sides, their backs, their hands, all this have to be because they love the money more than anything else, and they did not give the zakat, which is a principle. They have to give it.
Very good. Okay. Ayat 5. Those who abstain from of God their modesty.
Okay. See, that's another thing right there. Called the use of Aliyah, who abstain from sex. Mm-hmm. See, you know, which is really is those who guard their private parts. Mm-hmm. The private parts.
Okay. All right. Ayat 6. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ إِلَّا عَلَى أَزْوَاجِهِمْ أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مَعْلُومِينَ.
No, brother. إِلَّا عَلَى أَزْوَاجِهِمْ أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين. ملومين. ملكت.
إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين.
ما شاء الله.
Very good. Except with those joined to them in marriage bond, or the captive whom their right hand possess, for in their case they are free from blame. Praise be to Allah. And what we're learning from this is that we have to read the Arabic as it is.
Right.
We have to read the Arabic, the Quran, Arabic as it is. If we add something to it or take something from it, we're reading it wrong. So this is subtle. We have to be mindful of what we're doing. Praise be to Allah. Okay. Ayat 7. فَمَنْ اِتَّغَى وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْعَادُونَ.
الْعَادُونَ.
But those who desire to exceed those limits are transgressors. Okay, ayat 8. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَأَهَدِيهِمْ رَعُونَ. Those who faithfully preserve their trust and their covenants.
والذين هم على صلاتهم يحافظون.
Those who strictly guard their prayers.
أولئك هم الوارثون.
I said those who strictly guard their prayers. These will be the heirs.
والذين يرثون.
There's no way.
والذين.
No, no, no way. الذين.
I didn't say. Okay. I said والذين يا. I didn't say was. Yeah. Thought I said yeah.
والذين يرثون في الدوس.
There's no way, brother. There's no way. أولئك هم الوارثون الذين. Because he cannot add well to anything.
Right. No, that's completely. Yeah. That's not always there. You're right.
So I hear it well.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, it's not teacher. I'm a student.
I would read the head.
Yeah. Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah. I just have something to say about the ayah before that, which is وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يَحَافِظُونَ.
Okay.
It is ayah number 9.
Okay.
If you look, brother, this is ayah number 9. Look at ayah number 4. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. You see how zakat is came all the way before was salah?
Mm-hmm.
You say over in ayah number 4, say وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. Then in ayah 9, he say وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. He's on, then he, over here, he put the zakat all the way on the top. Mm-hmm. He was describing the people as the believers, the al-mu'minun.
Mm-hmm.
So the people is really al-mu'minun, they have to start with the zakat all the way on the top. So they have really to pay the zakat,
mm-hmm,
to be considered mu'minun even before they can do their prayers. You see, say, this is ayah number 4 and this is ayah number 9. And this is really catching my eyes now. Wow, mashallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was able to put this ayah all the way on the top and put this down. No. The sequence have a meaning over here. It's not just put like that.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Alhamdulillah. Okay. Who's at number 10, right? Number 9.
Yes, we doing number 9 now.
Number 9, okay. Okay. Yeah, I was.
Oh, no, you were saying that you were going number 11.
Number 11, right. Yeah, that's why I want to go back to number 11. I was saying Walidin. I don't know why. Right.
I
don't
know why you said it, because if you look at number 9, that got Walidin, see?
Yeah, okay.
9, so, and then I think it was 11, and part of 8.
Right. So
this is what I used to say about Walidin.
Yeah, I was stuck on that wall. Okay, we got to see. I say it again. We have to say what we see in the Quran. And what I was saying what I didn't see. We have to say what we see. Inshallah. Okay, ayat 11 again. Let me do it again.
الَّذِينَ يَارِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسِ هم فيها خالدون.
آيات 12.
ولقد خلقنا الإنسان من سلالة من طين.
I just want to make a comment about Al-Firdaus. That's the highest part of the paradise.
The highest part?
Yeah, the highest part. That's what we want to achieve. But they say in the highest part, we're going to have to start with the prophet himself. He's going to be funny. He's going to be in the highest. These people who was so far in advance and not just but the scholars and these people like that, you know. So we all need to be trying to achieve the highest part, not just gaining the paradise of the Jannah, but we want to go high in the Jannah. You know?
That's why in the da'wah we say, Allahumma atina al-firdaus al-a'la min al-jannah.
Right.
So the Firdaus is the highest. It's the highest.
Right. So now that when I said Al Firdaus, we talking about the paradise. We ain't talking about Jannatin, you know, the garden. Because see, once you're in Al Firdaus, and once you're in the paradise, no one would be cast from there.
Yeah.
But we know in the garden, you know, people were they said that. Adam and his wife was cast out from the garden.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right.
But that wasn't the paradise. A lot of people thought it was.
But the garden in the story of Adam was already in the earth. Mm-hmm. All the scholars proved that it was not in the Jannah, or it was not in the heaven, because they was already in the earth in this time. Allah put them in the earth to start, you know, making. So this was a paradise in the earth too, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him this blessing. Mm-hmm. But you know, David came out all this holy heaven. So.
Right.
Right. So it wasn't for those.
That's paradise. That's what we're trying to obtain. Paradise.
This is the highest level in the paradise.
But we're not gonna be in the high level. It's only problems only.
No. We can get to paradise too.
No, to the last level. Paradise.
Even if you get the last level, that's a blessing. You know, that's what you want.
It's only for the problems only.
No. It's
only for the people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose. You don't ever know who they are.
Right.
Because it's about your heart. It's for somebody might be in this time we live in earth, but you never know who is.
Right.
It's all about how faithful you are and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can see you, because you people cannot judge you, or people cannot see you, right? Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, he saw you.
But it's only 7 levels for those.
We say all Jannah is 7 levels. So
you
Allah,
said that.
Yeah, so the Firdaus.
And don't get confused now. Like we also said, the 7 heavens, because there are 7. See, this is what I'm saying about some of the authors. They use 7 heavens, like from the earth on up. There is 7 levels of the atmosphere. See, you know, and these 7 levels do different types of things for us. Help us out. Allah has put all the, some of them for radio waves. That's why we're able to transmit things. Prevent radiation from the sun. A lot of these things, you know, like sometimes people get skin cancer because they get too much radiation. So the sun is there, to, you know, certain level to protect us.
No, I'm saying like if we die, it'll be good. Maybe a good, not a good deal on scale, but we go to any level of Firdaus. Firdaus has 7 levels, right?
Uh-huh.
No, brother, let it confuse. Al-Firdaus is one of the levels on the Jannah.
Say it.
It is one of the levels.
One of the levels.
So the Al-Firdaus itself is one of the levels. So Al-Jannah have, like you say, have 7 degrees or 7 levels. So Al-Firdaus is one of the highest levels on the Jannah.
It's the last level.
Allah alam, it's one of the highest levels. I cannot say it's the last one.
Right.
Well, maybe there's a better one, Allah alam. But we say it is one of the highest level in the Jannah.
Mm-hmm.
So Al-Firdaus, that's because it's mentioned over here.
Yes.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, Al-Ladina yarithuna Al-Firdausa. Hum fiha khalidun. So he didn't say Al-Jannah, and we have too many verses say Al-Jannah.
Right,
but over here he said Al-Firdaus. So it is a very special place, it's very high quality living on the Al-Jannah.
So with that said, then that is for the human effort, the Firdaus is what we are striving for. That's what we know.
Exactly.
Yes.
That's what we everybody wish. He can we strive.
But Jahannam has 7 levels too.
Huh?
Jahannam.
Yeah, I guess Allahu Alam. We need to search deep on that. Yeah. The brother Imam can tell better than that. Then they have 7 depths. They say Jahannam, they say Sa'ir, they say it's too many, and all of them is in Quran.
Many names, right. But alhamdulillah, you know, we know
there's Nar Jahim, Sa'ir, Jahannam.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned from those, so this is what we want.
Yes.
We want that for sure.
That's what we
whatever,
want.
Whatever else Allah ta'ala have for us, that'll be our gift.
Yeah, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give it to all of us, inshaAllah. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma ameen.
Okay. Then ayat 13. ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً.
No, brother, you missed ayat 12.
12?
Yes.
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا. Yes, right, sure it is.
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقَنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ تِينٍ.
I read that already. You read it. But anyway, alhamdulillah.
Oh.
Okay, man, we did create from contestants of clay. Allahu Akbar. Then it says, ayat 13. ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينٍ.
ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً.
فَتَنْ ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُفَّةً فِي قَوْرَانٍ مَكِينٍ. And then we says, then we place him as a drop of sperm in a place of rest firmly fixed. Allahu Akbar. In coming on that.
In the womb.
Okay. ayah 14. ثُمَّ خَلَقَنَا النُّفَّةَ عَلَقَةً فَخَلَقْنَا الْعَلَقَةَ مُضْغَةً فَخَلَقْنَا النَّحْلَ
الْمُضْغَةَ
عِظَامًا.
That's important because Allah showing us the stages of
Allahu creation. Akbar. This is 1400 years ago, brothers. Yes. And this is exactly what happening. And no science were there. There was no x-ray. There was no scan machine they have, yes, right now. What do they call it? All this image. Ultrasound. Or image in resonance, ultrasound. Nothing on there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, ثُمَّ خَلَقْنَا النُّطْفَةَ عَلَقَةً. So a nutfa, this is number one. This is with a sperm. Mm-hmm. It turned to be alaqa. فَخَلَقْنَا الْعَلَقَةَ مُضْغَةً. So this is number three, مُضْغَة. Alaqa turned to be a مُضْغَة. A little bit bigger. So alaqa is like a little thing. Mm-hmm. So مُضْغَة is a little bit bigger. فَخَلَقْنَا الْمُضْغَةَ عِظَامًا. So that's number four now. Mm-hmm. And so in the first there was no bones. There's no عِظَام.
Right.
فَكَسَوْنَا الْعِظَامَ لَحْمًا. Then we cover those bones with meat. فَكَسَوْنَا الْعِظَامَ ثُمَّ أَنْشَأْنَاهُ خَلْقًا آخَرٍ. Then after that, we give him his face and his facials. How he looks. He looks different than anybody else. Nobody is looking like everybody. Mm-hmm. Finger, eyes, ears, whatever. Even so nobody can be identical.
Yeah.
Even the twins, they are not identical. ثُمَّ أَنْشَأْنَاهُ خَلْقًا آخَرٍ. So everybody is a different creation. خَلْقًا آخَرٍ. Right. فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. تَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ.
So bless me Allah, the best to create, who that created. Ayat 15. ثُمَّ إِنَّاكُمْ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ لَمَيْتُونَ.
You remember before we had a discussion in here, Muhammad, I think you was part of that, when we were talking about the Del Piyama, mm-hmm, and I said that everyone, every soul must taste death. Mm-hmm. So you said this verse right here, 15, saying that. You know, saying that everybody, said, then indeed after that, you are to die. So everybody going to die, even if it's only instantaneous. Let's say, for instance, that the Del Piyama is tomorrow. You're going to die. You know, even if it's just in the next 5 seconds, you're going to die first, and then Allah raise you up. Because he said, every soul shall taste death. And that is right there, 15, that you must die. We can't live forever. I mean, you want to, but we know it. But you gotta die.
Okay. 16. ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تُلْعَتُونَ.
تُبْعَتُونَ.
And on the day of judgment, you will be raised up.
Right.
Okay.
This is what you're talking about, Muhammad, right here.
Mm-hmm. After that, the length you will die, and on the day of judgment, you will be raised up. Inshallah. To the judgment, right?
Mm-hmm.
The judgment, subhanAllah. We have more hasana on a scale, inshallah. Ayah 17, we'll close it out with Ayah 17. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقَنَا فَوْقَكُمْ سَبْعَ طَرَائِقَ وَمَا كُنَّا عَنِ الْخَلْقِ غَافِلِينَ.
MashaAllah.
And we have made above you 7 tracks. And we are never unmindful of our creation.
See, that's a very important right there, because see, that's one of the miracles too. Like I was talking about, we got the back here, we got the stratosphere, the inner sphere, the exosphere. So all of these are 7 layers up. So this is the 7 layers. Now this is not the heaven, the jhana. This is not that. This is the 7 layers of the earth going up. Not the physical earth, but the sky. Mm. 7 layers going up. See. And Allah tells us to penetrate those. As a matter of fact, it says in Surah Luqman, penetrate those if you had it, but he said you would not be able to penetrate, go beyond the heavens
unless you got this unusual power like rocket fuel or something like that. But it's up to us to come up with that knowledge and where I'm about to do these things to penetrate. It means telling us to go on out there into space, go on out there and search and do what you got to do, but you won't be able to go out there unless you got to overcome these seven layers, seven heavens, and then go on out. So each one of these levels protect, thus has a purpose. Okay, so this is not the seven layers of heaven, but seven layers of the atmosphere.
Okay. Good, but the heaven itself doesn't have numbers.
So the heaven in general, they got levels there too. But we're talking about here, this here talking about the seven layers of the atmosphere on the earth. This is not heaven here.
Okay, alhamdulillah. Okay, all right, my dear brothers. Alhamdulillah, jazakallah khair. We appreciate us being here. And we just gonna get better.
Oh yeah.
We're gonna get better, inshallah. That should be our intention. May Allah bless us with a blessed week. Bless our families, our children, us all. Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as I greeted you, I will leave you with the greeting again. Assalamu alaikum.
Well,
alhamdulillah.